Alrighty, everybody. Welcome to day two of BCI. Here we have Ashley, and my name's Angie. And
morning,
welcome.
Everyone. Bit of a change in the weather this morning. Yesterday was a beautiful, sunny day, barely a cloud in the sky. Today, barely any blue. Well, no blue in the sky. Telstra Tower out there in the background, very obscured by fog. But the ultimate is about to start happening.
And we have here the Canberra team Factory, and from Brisbane we have Fuse. So teams are just about ready to start. The hoot is gone. All right, so it's looking like Factory's coming out on defense, so Fuse will be on offense.
Today we're going to be streaming three women's games if the weather holds up. There are some thunderstorms predicted later, so hopefully that steers well enough clear that we can keep playing. So three women's games, including a big showcase between Ellipsis and one of the rogue teams over lunch. And then the men's final will be streamed after that. And here we go for the start of day two.
Alrighty. So, looks like Factories are sticking with match defense.
Mo with the disc.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, bit over the head there.
Factory
bit of a
on
difficult
offense.
One.
Straight away looking to score a goal.
Oh, Jane Mo with the huge block. Jane Mo recently made the women's beach ultimate team, heading over to France next year. Oh, sorry, later in the year, sorry.
Mm-hmm. She's actually playing against one of her teammates today. Sekold from Factory is also heading over for Beach Worlds.
Deadwood on the mark. That should be a good matchup. Both very fast players.
And a run through block from Malumbi. Factory back on offense. And another block.
Bit low that throw, a bit hard to reel in, and Factory set up with a short field.
Malumbi picking up to Brown, swinging it across the bottom. Looking to really work this in and not rush it. And that's a goal by Crow.
Great crossfield throw there.
So that's one on the board for Factory. Fuse coming out on offense.
Factory currently sitting on a 1-2 record, beating Bauhaus yesterday, but going down to one of the rogue teams and Ellipsis. Brisbane Fuse, on the other hand, seem to be at 0-3 currently, having gone down to Rogue and Ellipsis, both very strong teams, and GWS Blaze, new team that we'll be streaming next.
And there's a replay of another block.
Great vision there on that throw. See the open player.
That's a great start of a game for Factory. Let's see what Fuse comes down with.
Don't know if you can tell in the stream, but a bit of a drizzle happening here. Not too heavy rain, but enough to make some throws come out a bit early if you're not careful. Not too much wind yet, so that shouldn't be a factor, but we'll see how the rain affects these girls' play.
Factory coming down with standard match defense. Grange almost getting a hand to that. And this is up.
Close, but a bit too much on that.
ED on this now. They've set up a side stack.
Straight away, going for the big one.
Bartram gets up. No, it's not Bartram, sorry. Yeah, apologies, that was Dawson. Watson now with the disc, looking end zone.
Big aggressive mark there from Kat Smith, putting some pressure on that, forcing the throw away. Yeep coming in with the disc.
Factory here with another chance to score a goal. ED to Watson. It is progressively getting wetter, so those catches will have to be... Yep, it's quite slippery, folks.
Bit too far for Wong. So that disc fading out to the side, possibly with that rain having an effect on the throw.
ED to Grange, looking for the swing, lovely swing. Factory looking to move this quite quickly, and deep shot from ED, looking for Dawson in the end zone, and that's a goal. So here's a replay. Quick movement from the handlers.
Huge separation there.
Great goal by Dawson. Looks like Factory's switching up the lines a little bit.
So straight out of the gate, two big breaks from Factory. Fuse will have to really punch this one in and come out with a break or two of their own before half if they want a chance of staying in this game. Number of times this weekend we've seen a few games where one team gets out to three or four breaks in the first 5 points and there's just no real way of coming back from that. Very, very difficult to string together enough breaks, have the mental strength to fight back through that.
True, although Factory has played a lot of games where it's a game of runs, so you know, a bit of back and forth, and so we'll see what Fuse can do. They've always posed a strong opponent for Factory, so hopefully Fuse can bring it back as well. There's the pull from Mullumbi.
Centering to Mo, up to Mueller.
Play.
She's getting some good movement here.
A bit of contact on that. It looks like there might have been a call. Here's the replay, so we can have another look at it.
Bit of float on that disc.
Bit of float. I think she felt like there was contact on the back of her arm, and there was a little bit on the back of her shoulder, so they're just talking it through now.
Ziegman seems to be taking possession of the disc, so gather it must be uncontested.
Uncontested.
Good to see some good spirit early on. Always sets the tone for a really good game when teams go, oh, benefit of the doubt, we'll give it to our opponents.
Looking to reset it. So it looks like a hand block or a foot block from Foster. Factory with another chance for a break. We've got Molumbi on disc now. And another turn and Fuse back in possession. The rain is coming down harder, so that disc is quite slippery right now, demanding a lot more focus from their players.
That was such a great opportunity missed there by Fuse.
Aya to Paul.
Right into traffic there. Really good block by Fuse. Rain getting a bit heavier now, so starting to be a bit more of a factor.
Looking deep.
The Savage gets some good separation. A lovely That's throw a great there grab. By Ava Mueller.
Lovely throw.
So Fuse resets. Look to come out strong on defense now.
So that's 2-1 to Factory. Here's a replay of that.
This of the foul.
Yep, this is of the foul.
Yeah, it looks really close.
It was quite close. There was some contact there, and it did look like she had a bit on it, so it seemed like a fair call there. And that was Claire Foster with a block.
Lovely, lovely around break there, but couldn't quite reel it in.
And another block from Fuse.
You see the defender here just getting on the back foot.
Great vision of the field, though, by Fuse.
Well, a lot of things happening in that point. Bit of a longer point, but Fuse will be happy to punch that one in.
The rain is coming down convincingly now, so Canberra's done a good job of bringing out all sorts of weather conditions for this tournament.
Kat Smith with a huge pull. Kat, one of the strongest women's ultimate in Australia.
Factory now on offense.
That
Bartram pull with the disc now.
That pull gives Fuse such a Dawson. Great opportunity to shut down the early movement of the handlers. But Factory doing a good job of moving it now.
Second now for disc to Deadman. Bartram, Crow and Brown doing quite a good job of the handler movement, Deadman as well, looking end zone to Cat. And that's a goal.
It's called in.
Called it in.
So Fuse pulling out some kind of zone here, maybe hoping that the strange weather conditions might cause an errant throw.
So let's just watch that handler movement again. Just chipping it around, looking for safe options, and seeing that option, fat side.
I look very close to...
Very close to the line, but...
Yeah, well...
Looks in.
Self-refereed. If everyone's happy,
right,
then we'll
right.
just move things along. We're seeing some action from the field next door.
So
Bauhaus
that's a
and is that Rogue?
That's Rogue, yeah. Playing on the other field.
We've got seven games happening at the moment in the rain. With 10 men's teams, 7 women's teams.
So a very athletic looking D-line from Factory. There's a few rookies this year. Some very talented players from the local university. Showing a lot of promise. Lots of athleticism. There goes the pool. Factory playing the usual match defense. And disc goes up. Factory's got a vision of it, but couldn't quite get a block.
Defender just out of position there, not really having good vision of where the disc was coming from, and Fuse capitalizes on that great huck.
That disc went over her head, but she had good vision of it, regardless. Here's a replay. Alrighty, so Factory currently leading 3-2 and coming out on offense now. We've got McDonald, Dawson, Hall, Malumbi, Aya, Barr, and Seckold on the line for Factory. Kat Smith with the pull for Fuse.
Another huge one
from
Kat Smith.
That is a great pull.
Giving Fuse plenty of time
well
to get down and set. I wonder if they'll use this
bit
zone
of a
again.
Fumble.
It does look like a zone again.
It's looking like a looser zone.
Ziegman with a great run through block there. Receiver just not quite attacking the disc maybe enough. Mm-hmm. And this would be a great boost to Fuse if they could punch this in. Down 2 breaks at the moment. It'd be great to get another break back.
Lovely cut.
Lovely break throw from Kat Smith. Vivian with the disc.
Oh, great hands.
Jane Moe, such safe hands. Wonderful movement
that
across
that was
to
Wong. Lovely. Great goal from Fuse.
So they're back in it. Right back in it.
That's right.
Breaking back. Thank you.
again with that pool, just huge pool.
I'll put my game advisor hat on and stay slightly offside.
A little bit offside. And
The pullers got to keep their feet behind the line.
Yep.
So something that we can all improve. And yeah, you can see the receiver there, just not quite attacking the disc, kind of waiting for it to come to them, and
lovely
Fuse quickly
movement.
Capitalizing.
Great connections on Fuse. They've all played together quite a bit, so it's lovely to see those connections on field.
Unfortunately, Fuse have been hit with a significant injury. Dom Simpson there on crutches, one of their long-time strong players, recently injured.
Alrighty.
This pool looks like it's sailed out of bounds.
So it looks like Brown calling a brick, and she'll bring it back in.
Fuse looking like they're coming out with this zone again. So had a bit of success with it last time.
Mm-hmm. Factory's picked up a couple players from the UK, Brown and Hind. So they're really excited to have them. We'll see what they do for Factory this game.
And through the cup.
Once
you're through that
movement.
Cup. That movement is a whole lot easier.
Not sure if that was in. That was out of bounds,
yeah,
by the looks
of
it. Yeah. So Fuse back in possession.
So it's worked again. That
has
zone
worked.
Is causing them some trouble.
That's right. They were looking pretty strong there with their movement, but Crow
that,
with a block there.
That high release
straight
coming
away.
Out with a bit too much float.
Brown to Hind and to Edie in the end zone for a goal. Factory looking to capitalize on that turn very quickly, swinging and moving it to score a goal. Here's a replay of that. So high release, straight to Crow's hands. Great read on that disc. And straight away, Factory looking to swing it for a goal.
Yeah, defender's very out of position there. I wonder if they were just caught up looking for their player on the transition. Mm. It's the advantage of quick movement near the end zone. Short fields, always so dangerous. Good to capitalize on.
Looks like we tried to get a shot of a downpour, but doesn't quite come up on the stream. It is easing up a little bit now, so... Not as heavy as before. So Canberra leading now 4-3. Fuse on offense.
Straight through the hands of Wong there, and Factory get to set up with the short field. So another opportunity to go up another break.
Watson with the disc, looking end zone. Great grab from Ringland.
Throw made a bit more difficult with a good hand block on the mark, but Factory able to come down with it.
Watson looking overhead. Dawson couldn't quite get a hands on it. Looks like might have been even a ground strip. Great bid. They're playing a bit of a containment zone here from Factory. Run through block from Grange.
Factory
Watson on disc.
At about the brick mark.
Looking for Deadman for a swing. And possibly a call there. Strip call.
Looks uncontested.
Uncontested. She's looking end zone for big outside in. Grange couldn't quite get control of that disc.
had position, read the disc well.
She did read it well.
Got it. Slippery conditions make the difference.
She's one of the factory's very athletic and talented rookies this year.
Breakthrough there from Moe to Smith. Melon Smith doing a bit of 1-2 action. But a very unfortunate slip there.
Dawson at the disc now to Deadman. Ringland again. And Hind.
Moe can't quite get there. Really, really good position, but the throw just beat her there. So Factory going up another break.
Here's another look at that awesome grab from Ringland.
Let's have a look at this. She had some hands on it, but just
think she had
bounced over chest and
bit of a ground strip there. Again, Grange with run through block. Watson looking end zone. That disc looks quite slippery. Ringland with a lovely throw. Lovely leading throw. All right. So
the rain's starting to come down a bit more now. It eased off for a while there, but
It'll be on and off all day, but probably getting maybe stormy later, so we'll see how we go with playing games. Mullumbi here with the pool. Mullumbi has played quite a few campaigns representing Australia in her Frisbee career. A very, very strong player for Factory.
Yeet picking up into Taylor, to Mueller.
Oh.
Mullumbi nearly with that, but not quite enough, not quite there.
Bit of a call there. Fuse here for another chance.
Oh, cheeky throw behind the defender's back there.
That's right. Looking to move that very safely. Chipping it around. Great movement. Oh, great hands.
Great pickup there.
Looking for that swing. It's not quite there. There it is.
In fact, Fuse's stack's a bit deep there. Fuse having to move it around the handlers.
Great hands.
So Factory keeping Fuse moving sideways mostly.
Yep.
A few meters here, a few meters back.
Oh, great bid.
Lovely bid by Ziegman, just a bit low for her.
So Factory here with another shot. Mullumbi walking up to the disc. It's going with a standard vertical play. Hall with a disc now. Barcham now on disc. All right, Fuse back on possession. Looking end zone. And that's a goal. This game has seen a lot of slippery drops, but Fuse making a great effort to focus in, take good options, focus on catching, and really prizing that possession. And it's paid off, putting another one on the board for Fuse. Here's a replay. Great hands. I believe that was Roe from Fuse, that pickup. Lovely movement.
And Dodd just able to get her defender on her back feet. Lost balance and just took advantage of that, going to the sideline for the easy score.
All right, Fuse of the pool, another lovely pool. Plenty of time for them to run down. I believe that's Brown on the disc to Edie and Deadman. Some strong handlers there.
Look like they're coming out with this zone again.
High release to Brown. Bit of a call there. Nope, there wasn't a call. Everyone just paused. Looked like a call. My apologies. Ah, it was a travel call. Factory moving it quite quickly. Lovely throw from Deadman to Emerson.
Fuse scrambling to get back into position.
Bar. Crow on disc now. Lovely handle work from Deadman and Edie.
The Fuse have now consolidated overhead. That zone. Fuse have now consolidated that zone and...
It's looking good. It's looking good. Putting lots of pressure, forcing Factory to move it from left to right across the field. Really, really making them work. But they are finding those gaps. They're broken through the wall. Emerson now on disc.
Once they get through that wall, the movement becomes a whole lot easier and they get just a few free meters. But Fuse doing a good job of consolidating and putting that pressure back on, making him go sideways again.
Edie looking for the overhead option. Look, spotting Hind in the end zone.
Mo with the block and doesn't look like a call.
It doesn't look a call. Hind thought about it, but probably thought she didn't have a play in that.
So that throws to a lot of players. I don't know whether the execution wasn't off or maybe it was just a moment of lack of patience trying to force something that wasn't quite there. Fuse doing a good job of keeping him out of the end zone. Mm-hmm. Eventually you just want to take that shot and don't think that one was on.
That's right. And Fuse was trying quite hard to trap Factory on the sideline and it worked. So
we have a timeout here called. Good opportunity to catch your breath after a lot of running in
that's
that
right.
cup. And a break, a break here would be huge for Fuse.
That's
down,
right.
Down one or two, I can't remember. A break here would be really helpful for them.
It's
to
just
get back in the game.
The other field with Banhouse and Rogue. I can't quite tell. I think the score is maybe 5-4, something like that. Can't quite. Oh yeah,
lovely
it's 5-4.
Camera work there,
thank
guys.
You, thank you for the lovely camera work. That's fantastic. Can't tell who's up, but looks like a very close game. His replay of that overhead. Hind looked like she had a play on it, but Fuse came down with a block.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure what the throw was looking for there. A lot of players standing
I think,
around.
Hind is pretty good in the air, so I reckon she was hoping that she could win that matchup.
Throw into the matchup.
That's right, throw into the matchup. You've seen it before. Alrighty, so it looks like they're just about ready. Alright, so timeout's just about over.
Fuse setting up in a horizontal. I don't know if we've seen that from them yet today. Factory setting up in some sort of zone. Oh, sorry. Yeah.
Oh, Emerson keeping a possession of that disc.
So Factory not able to capitalize on that timeout.
There's a pick called. Yesterday I talked to Max a lot about the stats involved with scoring goals off a timeout. So we'll see how this goes.
The theory is that timeouts don't work midpoint.
Yep, apparently 80% fail rate. And that's the goal from Factory.
Lovely around throw there, breaking that mark. Lovely around break there.
Great throw. And Bar there with the goal.
Lovely to see that spirit there from both teams, congratulating each other on good play.
So we have a Factory coming out on defense again. The pull from Mullumbi. Coming down match defense again.
Very close bid there from Mullumbi.
Yeah, lovely.
Well, this would be huge
Dawson
for Factory.
If Factory
could get this in.
McDonald to Watson. Watson on disc now. Looking end zone, not quite there. Back to Mullumbi. Now looking end zone to Dawson. Beautiful.
That is a lovely throw.
Great movement.
And so Factory go up 7-4 now, 1 point into half, able to take half now, which would be huge. Up, I guess, 4 breaks right now.
Is a replay of that intercept. There she is.
Good awareness there.
Great awareness. And straight away, chipping it to Mullumbi to get that disc moving.
And as that disc moved, that defender, who wasn't in a terrible position initially, as that disc moved, suddenly was caught out.
Lovely work by Factory.
And so will Factory take half here? What do you reckon, Angie?
Probably can't weigh in too much. This is my home team, so I might sound a bit biased. I reckon Fuse does have a good shot at bringing it back, though. So we'll see what they've got.
Fuse already shown that they can break Factory. They've done it once.
That's right.
They'll be definitely wanting to do it again right now. Well, not right now. It's not really a break. They want to score,
nice,
then
Ashley.
Break. Yeah. Expert commentating, game awareness right here.
They've got a strong line on, so...
So Factory recognises the situation.
They do. So we'll see what Factory comes down with. Maybe another containment zone to force Fuse to throw lots more swings. We'll see what they do. So that's Aya now with the pull. She's a recent pickup. She's just moved to Canberra last year sometime and started training with Factory. They're quite happy to have another strong handler on the team.
Kat Smith picking up and centering to Mueller. Bit of handler movement here to kick things off.
Kat Smith looking long.
And the receiver just probably needed to go for it there.
Yeah.
It's always tempting to turn back, look at the disc, but when you've got a thrower like Kat Smith, you just got to trust
that's
that
right.
It's going to be out in front of you.
And she's always looking to throw that, so that you could almost... can almost say that was a throw initiated, but I think her receiver just wasn't heads up enough. Hoping to see more of that from Kat Smith though.
And so Factory now with a chance to break into half.
That's right. Hall now with a disc with Crow.
Lovely upline.
Hall again. Looking long to Emerson. Gets a hand to it.
Oh, it's a one-on-one
beautiful
in the end
cut.
Zone. We'll should be able
walks
to capitalize
it back to
here.
The line. Looking to make a good option here to Bartram for a goal.
And so there we are, half
that's
time.
Half the factory.
So Fuse here with numbers, but just not picking up the right matchups as it got close to the end zone after that big huck. So well done to Factory taking half.
That's right, and Emerson did a good job of assessing your options. Instead of rushing it right outside the end zone, it's always tempting to throw straight away, but she was calm and collected on that disc, and it's got a goal. So
Fuse, can they come back in the second half?
What do you reckon they need to change up, Ashley, to bring it back to Factory?
That zone that they were having was working quite well. It forced a few turns, and they were just unable to punch it in. They've had some really good opportunities close to the end zone and just haven't been able to capitalize. The handler movement looks good.
It does look good.
Some very strong handlers on their team. So, look, tightening up some of those things, keeping on cutting hard and that defense, you know, I reckon it's got a good chance of making the difference in the second half. But we'll have to see. Factory looking really good on offense and patient through that zone. So I guess we'll wait and see. But we'll be back after halftime.
We'll tune back in soon.
Thank you.
And here we are, ready to start the second half. The cameraman running back with the coffee. Didn't spill all of it, he said. Mike and Rex doing a great job behind the camera today and yesterday.
Alrighty. Looks like a brick call.
Fuse coming out on defense, looking like they're still using that zone. Certainly quite a loose kind of zone.
Tried a shot through that wall, not quite there. Hughes of a chance now. With a big hammer for a goal.
That is a lovely hammer.
That is a great hammer.
Kat Smith to Vivian, lovely, lovely connection there.
Here's a replay of that. Love me a good hammer.
Really,
for a goal.
very thrower initiated there. Kat Smith just seeing the space. You went in the vague area. No defender really close to her. Let's throw that open every time. So Fuse coming out with a break, exactly what they needed to do to stay in this game. 8-5 now the score. If Fuse could go on a bit of a run, then this would be a very tight game. The mistake from Factory just coming off a pretty simple error. So if Factory tightens that up and just throws the good options, keeps working hard, then we've seen that they can beat this zone. But I guess that's part of what the zone's trying to accomplish, is look for that miscommunication or that simple execution error in the rain. Rain kind of eased off a bit now, just drizzling down, but obviously discs that hit the ground after a turnover are going to be a bit wet or off the pool. One good reason to catch your pulls. But another simple execution mistake there from Factory, and Fuse with a short field.
Factory need to work quite hard to get this back.
They've done a good job
looking
holding them up
swing.
So far. Good movement, but Ziegman's throw just a bit too low for the receiver.
Grange now on disc.
He's looking like they're trying to set up in this zone, and it looks like they've got that shape now.
Great positioning from Grange, and a big throw goes up. Halford Smith on the receiving end, right outside the end zone.
Not much the defender can do there.
Yeah, that's right. Straight to disc.
As with any zone that crowds four defenders around the disc, once you get it past those defenders, it'd be easy to win those matchups, four against two in the backfield.
There's a replay. Lovely, lovely throw.
And you see Factory flooding that end zone with three or four players.
That's
recognizing
right.
Their opportunity. Got to take advantage of that before the cup gets time to set up. When you woke up this morning in Canberra, you wouldn't have believed that it was going to get rainy and thunderstormy this early in the day, but it was blue skies.
It was beautiful. But as soon as people arrived at the field, it grayed over, started raining. It's eased off now, so... All right.
Moen Smith back handling. Set up out of a bit of a side stack for Fuse. Lovely hands there. From Viv Yuen, Monica Taylor.
Great hands. Looking long. Two receivers and Crow with a block. Bar there as well as backup.
That throw just had a bit too much float in it, or maybe was thrown a bit late, letting too many defenders get in the space. You can see the cutter is wide open, enough separation, but just a bit too much float on that, giving two defenders time to get in there, and that's always tough when you've got two defenders in the area.
That's right.
So Factory now with another chance to break.
Her eye on disc now.
And Fuse now using more of a man match defense.
Circled now on disc. And doesn't quite complete.
Bit of a miscommunication there, and Fuse with a good opportunity to punch this one in. Cassie's picking up and immediately trying to generate something from the handler position.
Lovely give go.
Not quite in there from Yuen.
Oh, lovely.
Kat Smith with the jink, taking matters into her own hands.
Showing a team how it's done, leading by example. Such a great player. Here's a replay.
Kat Smith immediately after that throw, trying to create something, jumping into that space, getting a defender out of position. And
there it is.
There it is.
Lovely shoulder control there. So we've got Factory back on offense. Let's see if Hughes comes down another zone defense. Pool goes up. Willumby receiving, looks for Edie. And it is indeed a zone. Factory will be looking to be safe with their options. Try to break through that zone.
Mueller and Ziegman are deep, stopping any long options there and forcing Factory to move around in the handler space.
That's right.
Factory being patient though.
There are handlers and poppers working together. They're all quite active, looking for those gaps, trying to generate space. Edie on disc, really wanting to break through that cup or get around. She's thrown it over. Malumbi on disc now. Looking end zone. Beautiful.
And Miller seemed to slip there. I don't know whether she had a foot on the line that's marked for the soccer field, which has got a bit of an indent in it, or whether it's just the slippery conditions, but seemed to give a lot of space there for the open receiver.
That's right. Here's the replay. Mullumby keen to get to the end zone. Spots Hine.
We can see Mueller running across to try and cover help out on defense on the far side of the field, but great vision from the thrower to see the cutter or the receiver that left open on the other side of the field, and Mueller just losing her footing there.
The field must be quite soggy right about now, so it's tough on the players to remain sure-footed. Watson of the pool.
Mueller and Moe back to handle with Kat Smith. Setting up, looks like out of a side stack.
Oh.
Ziegman can't come quite down. Trying to catch the trailing end of the disc, always so difficult, especially when the disc is wet.
That's right.
But valiant effort.
Emerson on disc now.
Dodd sitting up on the mark.
Dawson couldn't quite get the disc. She's looking deep straight away. Oh, great bid. Watson back on disc.
Fuse in a match defense now.
They're doing some lovely handler movement. McDonald on disc now. McDonald recently recovered from an ACL injury, so it's great to see her back on the field. Back to Watson, looking at longer with a...
Lovely awareness there from Ziegman. Her cutter not the intended receiver, I don't think, but good vision to have a look and make the play. Taylor. That throw not quite coming off how she liked it, I don't think.
That's right. McDonald got her fingertips to it as well, so pushed it right off course. Emerson picking up now. Just out of reach.
It's not quite enough touch on that throw.
That's right.
It's difficult for the receiver to get there. And Smith wide open in that dump space. You just know she's looking for the end zone, but end zone was covered well by the Fakra defenders and forces a throwaway.
Emerson now back on disc. Halford Smith. Throws a bit of a high disc, but Watson comes down with it. She's looking end zone to Deadman. That looks like a block from Fuse.
Lovely defense there. Mm-hmm. Harriet Berenger. So Fuse setting up in a bit of a horizontal there.
Lovely throw.
Cutter getting open, but just can't hold on to it. It's one of those execution errors that's been hurting Fuse today.
Emerson on disc now. Oh, a bit of a misread on the handler's cut. Couldn't quite get her hands on it.
And so now Fuse will have another chance.
That's right. It's huge. She's got a play streaking deep. Let's see if she connects. Oh, great bid. Not quite there.
That throw made a lot easier by the fact that the factory defender tried to make too much of a bit on it, leaving Kat wide open. Always a danger when that throw is so strong. You can see the factory defender there.
Let's watch it again.
Leaving Kat with just any throw up to her.
That's right.
But Ziegman not quite able to get there. Ziegman's such a fast cutter and always willing to lay out.
Great bid though. Watson back on disc. Looking for Crow again. Slippery hands from both teams. Just the last couple percent of focus.
Moo picking up. Lovely touch break throw. Mueller can't quite get there.
It's been quite a long point. Quite a lot of turns. Again, with another turn. Neither team wanting to give it up. Without a fight.
I love seeing this fight. This is exciting.
It is great. And both teams are pretty amped up.
So Kat Smith do the strike. Will she look for a dump? Try and generate something.
Wow. A block, but still a goal. That was a great point. Both teams fighting really hard for that.
Kat Smith just wanting to finish it. Been
That's
a long
right.
point. Let's get our other line on the field.
That's
and
right.
Mueller making a great upper line cut.
They're all smiles. Pretty glad that's over. On to the next point. Here's a replay.
She's got a hand on it.
That's
but
right.
Great adjustment there to hold on to that.
Yeah. Crow always heads up for a good block, but Fuse came down with the goal.
Here's Ziegman again. Always laying out. I've seen her catch many, many disc very close to the ground, but these slippery conditions just making it so hard for everyone today.
It is fun to lay out when it's wet, so who can blame her? Oh, so close
so
on
close.
That bid.
That disc just fading a bit to the right there made it slightly more difficult. Ziegman everywhere on this point.
That's right. Fuse at the pool. Grange now on disc, straight to Edie. Grange, such an athletic and talented addition to factory.
Fuse seem to be returning to more of a match defense style, hoping to just win this one with their legs.
That's right. Factory returning the favor with some beautiful movement, really quick, safe options. Foster with a great grab. Great grab for a goal.
Savage is right there. It was very good defense, but Factory just winning the contest there.
That's right. Edie and Grange with some really quick, agile handler movement, helping them win that point.
Let that be a lesson for everyone watching. Going up with two hands wins the day. Especially in these sorts of conditions that I've seen many people drop easier catches than that. Going up with two hands. Even if one of your hands fails, your other one's there. Finish the job.
Malumbi now with the pull.
In fact, we're just needing four more points to put this game away. Fuse needing eight more, so bit of an ask, but I believe, Angie, I believe.
I reckon they could do it. Anything can happen in Ultimate. Fuse is a great team, so if they want it bad enough, I reckon they could do it. They've got the time. Looking long. Oh.
Wow.
Just over ahead.
Could have had a second bid on that as well, the other Fuse player, but they're tough.
Oh. Molombi looking behind. Behind gets it, throws it deep.
Receiver
Dawson's
wide
there.
Open.
Great grab.
Jinx.
It's good to hear we're in sync, Ash. Here it is again. Molombi looking for the upper line behind. Lovely grab, body behind it, looking end zone. Dawson quite free in the end zone. Lovely grab.
Yeah, it looks like the defender thought that wasn't going up. Kind of stopped her her cutter kept going deep, and she just kind of peeled off thinking maybe the throw wasn't going to come. So hard to read a disc behind you. So it looks like we have a timeout here. Not sure who has called it. Whether the Fuse wants to use this as an opportunity to reset and try and get back on a roll, or factories recognize, hey, it's three more points, that's it. Let's try and get it done in 3 points.
Alrighty, so looks like we're ready to get back to it. And looks like Hind with the pull for Factory, and Fuse is just about ready to play another offense point.
Looks like a few Fuse players getting the grass out of their cleats. Always a good idea to get that extra grip.
That's
as
right.
The grass wet grass sticks to your cleats.
Good thing we're not playing in winter, because in Canberra the grass frosts over, so you basically wind up with grass ice on your cleats by the end of the night. So I'm glad it's not that cold for them.
And it's not pleasant to pull it off either.
That's right.
Fingers frozen enough already. All right, here we go out of the timeout.
Fuse looks ready to go. Bit of a rolly pull from Factory. That's always fun. A few giggles from the sideline. Playing a zone.
Very loose zone.
Quite loose.
Trying to slow Fuse down, make them throw a lot of throws, maybe force an error, maybe get them impatient, or maybe just run out the clock, knowing that there's only 9 minutes left in the game.
Fuse with some good-looking movement, lots of popping.
Yeah, no issues, no unsafe throws, but also not gaining many meters. Factory doing a good job further downfield of stopping any safe long options.
Smith is definitely looking through that wall, but the options aren't quite there. Few's trying to get their teammates to play a bit wider to spread the game across the field.
Yeah, that's it. If you can move that defense, try and change the angle, find some gap, get it through that cup, and then it's just easy
and
days to the end
block.
Zone. But
oh.
Not this time. Containment zone working.
And there was a call. Looks like a foul call on that, on the mark. Uncontested, comes in on zero. Second on disc now.
Zygmunt biting pretty hard on that, opening up that throw, but.
Oh dear.
Malcolm can't come down with it.
It does get tricky to read when it goes over your head.
Need to take a few steps back.
Mm-hmm.
Plenty of room.
That's right. And sometimes by the time you turn around, it's too late. So that's always a tough one.
It's a tough gig.
Fuse again, working the zone. They're looking pretty good. Cat really wanting to throw it through that wall.
Barringer not able to hold on to that one.
Edie to Sekold, looking end zone to Malumbi for a goal.
Lovely touch there from Sekold, giving her receiver the opportunity to attack it wherever she wanted.
Here's a replay of that. Edie
Sekold
looking
wide open. Yeah, it looks like Taylor almost got a fingertip to that.
That's right.
Maybe even made it slightly floatier and easier to bring down in the end.
That's true.
And so Factory only 2 points away from taking the game.
That's a replay of Malumbi's hand block on that. There's another attempt at a goal for Factory, and it did go over her head. She got a hand to it. And again with that goal.
Yeah, definitely some fingertips there.
That's right.
Just put some air under that disc, made it sit up a bit easier. So, unfortunate there for Fuse not to get more of a piece of that.
That's right. It did happen to Factory earlier. Factory... they got a hand to a disc for a block. That was Crow, I believe. And then Fuse still scored it. So a bit of back and forth in this game of those.
Can't really say catch your hand blocks, can you?
You can if you want, but seems like a rough ask.
Have you ever seen anyone catch a hand block, Angie?
I have actually seen a Callahan video where the player laid out and caught the throw. It was
after
incredible.
Hand blocking it, they then...
No, they blocked it and caught it. It was pretty sensational. I'll see if I can find it.
So Yip and Yun creating some handler movement here.
Lovely movement, great cuts. Moving it so quickly. Some great offense,
and
slowing
Yuen
it down.
With Yun wide open, and
beautiful.
That's all too easy. That's looking a lot better from Fuse.
They're all smiles. Great offensive point.
They're enjoying themselves here in Canberra.
There's a replay of that.
Lovely up the line cut from that far handler space from Yunan. Doing all the work on that point there.
I do love those up the line cuts. Definitely one of my favorites. And very effective for... moving that disc quickly. They pretty much play that point up the sideline. Yep. Pretty much a clear run. All right, so we've got Smith again with the pull. Factory coming down on offense. Looks like they're ready to go. McDonald picking up that pool.
Staying in bounds, so McDonald having to take it from the end zone.
Brown, though, with the disc. They're going to have to work it through Fuse's zone.
Oh, no. That disc slipping out of McDonald's hand in the wet. Fuse with a very short field.
I feel for her. That's the rain doing its work.
And Smith here asking, I need something to happen.
Oh. Lovely throw.
Jane Moe presenting that option. Getting her feet in bounds before being carried out of the end zone. So an easy one there for Fuse. Got to ask the question. Could they come back at this point? Time cap will be going in about 2 minutes.
Lovely pull. Right into that corner. Stays in.
That's such a lovely pull. Get that one throw off and you're just on the end zone line. And here's that. Very unfortunate throw out of the hands. Kat Smith going, what's happening?
What's happening? Where are
Mo
the cuts?
Mo realizing her defender's behind her.
That's right.
Trusting that inside break from Kat Smith will come. A set.
Again, lovely shoulder control. Gets in front. Earns her a goal.
And that fog really comes across Canberra now.
Oh, that's right. Can sort of make an outline of Telstra Tower.
Here in the inner north area of Canberra.
Both teams looking like they're having a great time. And Factory looks ready to go.
So the rules here at BCI for ending the game, once the hooter goes in 1 minute, the players will finish the point that they're currently in. And then whoever's on the highest score will add one to that, and that is the final target. So even if the hooter goes, Fuse will still have a chance to come back, but they'll have to get three or four in a row.
That's right. Edie now, one of the main handlers in the zone offense. Edie took a season off last year, and they're very happy to have her back. Oh, great block.
Vivian there again with the block. She's everywhere today. Kat Smith picking up, looking straight for the end zone.
Look, she's looking big.
And Malombi is there to shut down the deep option.
Oh, great hands.
And that is great cutting. Going to the end zone, providing that threat, forcing the defender to go with it, and then getting a big gainer under.
That's a great toss from Smith into the end zone and a block. So it looks like there was some contact there. She's making sure the Fuse player's okay. Looks like she's all right. So there's looks like there's no call and the turnover will stand. Bartram now with the disc and Fuse with their zone.
Fuse setting up a bit more of an aggressive zone this time. So right up there, their other players 3 meters away from the thrower.
That's right. They've managed to break through that zone, though.
And Fuse is scrambling to get back into position. Factory taking advantage of this time while the cup is still moving. The cup position, but Factory's gained some big meters there.
That's right. Now they're just working it, swinging it around. Malombi now on disc. Bartram to Edie. They really don't want to get trapped on the sideline now. Makes their work a lot harder. Then the overhead to Foster. Straight to Malombi for a goal.
So game to 15.
Indeed, game to 15.
So big ask now from Fuse. 6 points in a row required.
Mm, Lovely grab there. Here's that goal attempt again. Deadman getting a hand to it, but there was a big collision with a Fuse player.
Yeah, got to be careful with those ones. The rules of the 2017 update of the rules is really clarified that, of course, this was always the rule, but when you make a play on the disc and initiate contact, doesn't matter whether you initiate that contact before, during, or after making contact with the disc. The whole thing has to be clean, so...
That's right.
Got to be careful, even if you get... Yeah, touch that disc first and then run into your opponent, that can still be a foul.
Yeah.
Or it is still a foul, and... yeah, we want to be careful. Frisbee's a non-contact sport. Mm. Always wanting to be careful to avoid contact. As we see some more right there. Always difficult to track the disc when it's behind you. You're running... without looking where you're going. Not looking where you're going, never an excuse to initiate contact. So it's a tough place to be in.
Yeah, definitely. And everyone's got their eyes on the disc, so don't always glance around to see where the other players are, so it does get a bit dangerous sometimes.
A bit of a throwaway there. Not quite enough touch from Fuse and Factory. Now with the chance to finish off the game on a break.
That's right, and last season Factory worked really hard on closing out games, so here's a chance for them to practice that. Oh, was that a greatest attempt?
Good bid. We'll see what...
I think that was a greatest attempt. It worked, it stayed in, so...
Few seems happy to take the disc from there.
Definitely.
Are they? So
I think they will. It stayed... Technically stayed in the field. Dawson just smacked it back in.
Oh, but... Yeep can't quite come down with it, and Factory now
Grange
in a very short
up.
Field.
Yeah. And Dawson with a goal to close out the game. She celebrated after getting that greatest back into the field, so that was fun.
It's not often you celebrate a throwaway, but
in that circumstance,
you're pretty happy with your effort.
That's right. And she did technically throw it closer to their end zone, so...
Gain a few meters. Be happy with that. Turn a turnover with yards, why not?
That's right. And here's a replay of that final goal. It's Watson to Dawson to close out that game.
Signaling to the thrower, put it here. I'm going to be open in a second. Let me do the work.
And that's always great to see. Lots of trust between players. Just please throw it. I'll go get it. It's like, all right, here you go. Have a great time of it. And it does look like Fuse and Factory had a lot of fun in that game. Here's another replay.
So Factory coming out on top 15-9. So for Factory, I believe that's their second victory of the weekend. Fuse still looking for their first. So good luck to them for the rest of the tournament. Hopefully they can come out with a win. Stick around in 15 minutes. We've got GWS Blaze taking on Factory again on this field. GWS, I believe, a new team formed from... various other ones around the area.
I think there's some like Sand Dunes players from back in the day as well on that team. For example, Hannah Monty is on that team. So lots of talent.
Rain
It'll be a tough matchup for Factory.
Rain is getting quite heavy, so hopefully fields stay open. Hopefully lightning stays away. And we'll see you in a few minutes.
We'll keep you updated.